Hi, I'm Daphne Richards, and this is Augie. We've got lots of questions this week, from pathogens to insects. Joan Ludke's white rose bushes are usually full of blooms, but recently they started wilting, and now the stems are completely black. We suspected a microbial problem, so we checked with Extension plant pathologist Kevin Ong, who suspects Phytophthora, a soil-borne pathogen that causes plants to crater and die seemingly overnight. First, dig up and toss this plant, then allow the soil to dry out completely. Phytophthora is usually only problematic if the soil is staying too wet. Be sure that there aren't any drainage issues in this area and wait a while before replanting. Unfortunately, once you have it, Phytophthora will always be in the soil, so you want to control the environment as much as possible to ensure that it can't become a problem again. Now, what's going on with Nance Hyam's Yaupon holly? 2 years ago, it was covered with tiny, scale-like bugs and looked unhealthy. Topical treatments for the scale insects did no good, so reluctantly, she used a root systemic which seemed to help. This spring, the tree budded out nicely, but now the foliage is dying and it looks sparse. Will it recover? What should she do? Unfortunately, scale insects are not normally gotten rid of with a single treatment, and usually once their population booms on a plant, it's pretty stressed and may never fully be rid of them and recover completely. But to give this yaupon a fighting chance, you should prune out all of the dead branches and twigs to encourage new growth. Also, supplemental irrigation if there's no rainfall and a little fertilizer to kickstart growth will help, especially during the early stages of recovery. Next, what's this damage on Thin Bui's oak tree? Was it caused by disease, insects, or animals? These are twig galls caused by gall wasps. Similar to leaf galls, twig galls are tissue created by the plant in response to insect infestation to protect the growing larva inside. The galls on this tree have decayed and begun to break apart now that the adult insect has emerged and vacated the premises. Gall-inducing insects usually cause minimal damage to smaller twigs, not larger branches, so just keep an eye on the problem. The insects are gone now, so there's no need to treat. Sam and Vicky Strauss are wondering about the leaves sprouting all along the trunk and major branches of their live oak. Is this okay? It actually is. This is just a habit that live oaks have. If you don't like the look of all those extra leaves, simply remove them. But they aren't hurting anything. And since it's the plant's habit to produce them, those leaves will come back. So you'll need to remove them every year or two if you want to keep those branches clean. And from Basin PBS, Mark Patton in Midland asks, can I plant Pluot trees in Midland? We asked Extension fruit specialist Jim Comas for his advice. And he says that he's seen them around Texas, but notes that they usually have problems in our climate since they were bred for California conditions. Unfortunately, here in Texas, they don't bear fruit consistently. They're finicky about pollination, and they're very cold sensitive. They're also susceptible to leaf spot and bacterial canker. Our plant of the week, kangaroo paws, comes from San Antonio viewer Janet Morrow. She reports that this Australian plant does quite well for her in containers and in the ground. Listed as hardy only to zone 10, Janet reports that they may or may not come back after winter in her zone 9A garden, though hers have returned when pruned to the ground in winter, treating them as a perennial. Kangaroo paws do need full sun, good drainage, and very little water. There are many varieties of sizes and colors, and some may get to 6 feet tall, but Janet's are smaller ones, which she jokingly calls wallaby paws. Kangaroo paws bear tubular, velvety flowers that spike from grassy foliage. Janet tells us that they bloom continuously in warm weather, if you remove spent flower stalks from the base. Hummingbirds and butterflies love them, and they also make long-lasting cut flowers. We have some great viewer pictures this week. Swallowtail butterflies love dill to lay their eggs. Wendy Ramos was thrilled to find the striped caterpillars munching their way to pupation on her dill plants. In Mills County, Larry Mangum's dwarf pomegranate is covered in frilly orange flowers. Angela Carver's Louisiana iris put on a lovely lavender show during the rain. And last spring, Diana Saunders spotted monarchs sipping nectar on her mountain laurel blossoms. By the way, you should be seeing next year's flower spikes emerging now, so keep an eye out if you're pruning. We'd love to hear from you. Check out klru.org/ctg to send us your questions, pictures, and videos.